video, I will help you understand the Shirawood Suri variety, how to select them, and how to select koi with a lot of potential. So next to Kohaku, Sanke and Showa, a very popular variety is the Shirawood Suri. The Shirawood Suri are two-colored koi with black and white markings. This variety is traditionally selected from the Showa, so it are Showa essentially without any red markings. The most famous and known breeder in Japan for Shirawood Suri breeding is the Omosako Koi Farm. This farm has delivered several parent koi to several other breeders in Japan, including, for example, the Kaneko Koi Farm. For this reason, we also have some Shirawood Suri of breeder Omosako in this bowl. These koi are nearly 2 years old, about 40 to 45 cm in size. And I have to say, maybe it is good to know, that these koi tend to have a slightly more yellowish head, yellowish skin, and that is because in the last couple of months these koi have been growing indoors in the last couple of months, and for that reason a lot of food is used with protein in order to maximize growth. That means for this reason the skin also tends to become a little bit more yellowish, but that is no problem at all, because if these koi go to a little bit colder temperatures, let's say 5 degrees less, a little bit less food, less protein containing food, the skin will become crystal clear white again. And well, these koi are really from high quality, a lot of potential from the Omosako Koi Farm. So really good for this video to explain you more in detail how you can select good quality Shirawood Suri and what to look for. And maybe it is nice to start with why it actually is really nice to have Shirawood Suri and look at the development in the next couple of years. Shirawood Suri really will develop intensively over the lifetime of the koi. And often in the first year, Shirawood Suri have semi-visible underneath the skin. So I will start this video with explaining you about sumi. Sumi are the black patterns. What the differences are in sumi and what to look for on Shirawood Suri, and for that reason I have three kind of different looking koi in this bowl as well. All of the same breeder, all 2 years old, all around 40 to 45 cm, but still a lot of differences. What you can see on this koi is a lot of sumi. And it is good to know that Shirawood Suri have a black base. So when they are young, around 1 week old, the entire koi is light black looking. So that's what the breeder selects them on. But at a later age, sumi will develop and come up. So this Shiro is quite well developed. So this sumi, I will lift it a little bit. You can see there is still white visible in between the scales. And it's no problem at all, because this is a young koi, it is 2 years old. It still has a long way to go. It will get really, really dark. So this koi, one side is really black. So this side, super black. Other side, more a pattern visible, white, black, like that, like a zebra. It's quite nice. Then the next one, I will use the second one, this one as example for underdeveloped sumi, but sumi that will develop. This koi has really high quality sumi, really good quality sumi, but what you can see is especially on the shoulder section, so like this, shoulder section, this area, this is sumi that is visible under the skin. So you can look through the skin, look on the sumi, it is still grayish, bluish looking, it will become super dark later on. It can take quite a while, like 2 years, 3 years maybe even, but that's totally fine. So big differences between these two koi. This koi already quite intensively developed sumi. This koi as well. For 2 years old, a little bit too intense in my opinion, looks really good, but this koi for now has the best sumi. You can see on some places, top of the gills, tail area here as well. really high quality sumi is visible, shiny sumi is visible, but most of the sumi is still underneath the skin. It needs to develop here as well, here as well. So a lot of time to go, but that is only good. You want sumi to come up really slowly. So, and then we will talk about Motoguro. Motoguro, I have to say. Motoguro is black markings in the core of the pectoral fins. And I have some nice examples also to give you explanations. So this Shirabutsuri has a little bit overdeveloped Motoguro in this fin and underdeveloped sumi in this fin. What you actually want is well-balanced Motoguro. And this is the best example I have now in this bowl. If you turn around to the camera, look at this, 50-50%, very well developed Motoguro in the pectoral fins. And when a koi is young, under 2 years old in age, it already should show Motoguro visible. Even if the rest of the body doesn't show any developed or well-placed and developed sumi yet, it already should have Motoguro visible in the pectoral fins. So if you have a younger koi with less developed sumi like these three, if there is a little bit of Motoguro only visible in the core, it already hints you, it reveals a little bit and says, okay, look, my sumi is strong enough, I will come up later on. Most important for Motoguro is that it is well developed and balanced over the pectoral fins. So equally divided, so, because if the koi is large, let's say it is 70 cm and one fin is entirely black, other is white, it will show a little bit of imbalance. And this koi, this Shirabutsuri, is a good example of imbalance. Both on the pectoral fin, black pattern, other side too white, and a white fin. If this koi is large, well, it is a little bit imbalanced and that won't look very, very good in your pound. However, well, it is still a nice koi, of course. Then something about the pattern. I think if we talk about pattern, of course, this is something personal. And for this reason, I won't pay a lot of attention to it in this video. And honestly, there is also not a lot to explain about the pattern of a Shirabutsuri. Most important is about 50 or 60% sumi maximum for a well-balanced pattern. So white and black in balance. Make sure at both sides of the koi there is about the same amount of sumi visible for a well-balanced pattern. But what is important for Shirabutsuri, also for Showa by the way, but this is only about Shiro, is the head pattern. We have to look for the head pattern at two aspects. And that is the Menware and the Hachiware. A Menware is referring to the V-shaped pattern on the black that is visible on the koi. This actually is a good example of a V-shaped pattern on the head. What you want is 50-50 white and black on the koi. Black markings should cross like half of the head, like this one, with a black marking in between the eyes. This one has the same thing, but it will have to develop a little bit more. You can see the head between the eyes, black is coming up. And where my finger is pointing now, more black is underneath the skin. So it's still light black visible, but it will come up. So it is also a good Menware. And then we also have the Hachiware. Hachiware literally means divided head. It is a lightning kind of pattern in between the eyes, and it goes up to like the shoulder section. So Menware and Hachiware, it is almost the same, I would say. Hachiware would be like, for example, on this koi, if sumi will develop, and it starts nearly at the nose, the mouth of the koi, and then up to the shoulder with like a lightning pattern, like in between the eyes. We call it Hachiware. Not a lot of people talk about it. Mostly what you can hear is Menware. So keep that in mind. So the last thing I will explain you about pattern is when you look at sumi markings, you want to make sure On Shirabatsuri, there are large patches of sumi visible. So large patches, large areas of black. So not only small dots, for example, but large patterns. So taking this one as example, because it is most developed, large patches, large patch, large patch, large patch. That is important. This one as well, this side as well. A large patch, more large patches. On the head as well, large patches. Not only dots, but large patches. That is most important. And you also want to make sure, because it will make the koi look stronger and more elegant when it is larger, that the sumi goes to the bottom, to like the belly of the koi. So not only on this part sumi visible, but like on the whole side. That is also something you have to look for. Then the next item is super bright white skin. It sounds strange, but if you have perfectly developed black on a Shirabatsuri, but the white is not that white at all, but it looks yellowish, like these koi have now a little bit on the head, it makes them less nice, because the black just doesn't look as black. When the white is super white bright, it has a little bit of shiny luster, and often you can see luster in this area, like shiny small parts. These are indications for good quality shiroji, good quality white. A lot of Shirabatsuri, especially on the head section, also as these ones have, especially when they are growing at a younger age, will have a little bit, well, kind of eggshell, a little bit of yellowish, eggscale looking colored heads. And this will be totally fine. It will become more white. Just give it some time. Body posture is also one of the key things to look at when selecting a good Shirabatsuri. You want to make sure that the Shirabatsuri has a well-developed body and has potential for the future. And honestly, when selecting koi, I've selected a lot of Shirabatsuri in Japan, it is one of the most easy varieties to select. But it actually becomes more difficult when the koi become 2 or 3 years old, because then body posture needs to be taken into account as well. And especially when you want the koi to grow really large. So a good body posture is key for a magnificent and elegant look when the koi grows larger. You want to make sure Shirabatsuri have a strong backbone visible when the age is around 2 years old. Backbone is called Jitai in Japanese. This is a backbone. It is like the shoulder area. And it actually is explaining the body of the fish just behind the head. So from this up to the highest point of the body, which is around here. So only this section. And as you can see, this one is quite a high one. It's really high. But for example, this one is a little bit less high. Still quite high, but it is less high. And what it explains, what it tells, is how much body and weight can be put into the shoulder area. So the sides of the fish will grow up and the shoulders will become more massive. Now the shoulders are like this, but it will become like this. Of course, it is not really the holy grail, if I'm honest, but a lot of people look at it. And a too high jitai is also not good. So this one is a little bit too high. It has like a lump, like a really high lump, a little bit too much, honestly. So yeah, well, it is a good indication at least. Well, there should be backbone visible. That's most important. Something else you want to look at is if there is already a belly visible. You don't want too much belly visible. You want a torpedo looking koi. So this one, if I turn it, is torpedo looking. You can probably see it. It is quite straight body line. Important at a young age. And 2 years is still young for a koi. Of course, it is super young. This koi with the higher section, if I put it like this, what you can see is that actually it is well, a little bit of short body conformation. It is too high. The first part is too high. The tail doesn't look that strong. It is a little bit soft looking. It is broad, but not high. And a lot of people talk about a strong tail, so a broad tail area. The Ozutsu should be broad, they say. Not the most important factor, honestly. It is important, but the height, the height of is also important. So how high is it? This one is quite low. This one is also not super high, but so especially this one has for now the best body posture. Maybe not the best pattern, but it has best torpedo looking, high tail, broad tail, the jitai, the backbone is high, shows more growth can be put into there, more weight can be put into this area to make it look more massive and big when it is larger. And something you really have to look for, and best thing to ask your koi dealer or do it yourself, ask if you can do it yourself, if you can turn around the koi, turn it around and look if on the belly orange is visible. And orange, why orange? Because I mentioned before, this variety is bred by using Showa, well, years and years ago. Now, of course, parent koi are also shiro tsuri, but it actually started with Showa without any red visible. And these became shiro tsuri. So some shiro tsuri tend to develop, especially on the gills, on the bottom of the head area, next to the pectoral fins. Often secondary he will develop, so secondary red. It looks really orangish, but it will in the end become a little bit darker red, and it of course doesn't look good. Then you have a black white koi, or a black and white koi with small red dots like at the bottom of the body area. Doesn't look very good at all. So overall, what I explained to you in this video is that you have to look for a well-balanced pattern. 50% white, 50% black. Look for the menwaren. The head 50% black, 50% white. In between the eyes should be some black. Make sure the motoguru is well balanced and there is motoguru visible. Make sure, just like this koi, not all black is already super developed when it is young. When it is not older than 3 years old, make sure there is still semi-visible underneath the skin. I mentioned you about the body posture. I mentioned the backbone. Look at the backbone. It should leave some space for the koi to get bigger in this area, to look more massive when it is larger. I also mentioned about the tail section, broad tail area, but also most important, so even more important than how wide the tail section is, that it should be high. And also look for especially the gill plates, the bottom of the head area, the belly section, that it doesn't have secondary red visible. No red visible, no oranges looking red should be visible. And I think if you take these key criteria to select a shiro tsuri, I'm really sure that you can also select a good one. So if you have any questions about shiro tsuri selection, feel free to add it in the comments. Ask me, I will try to answer it, try to help you, and so we can make sure that you are going to select a good shiro tsuri. Thank you for watching again, and if you like these kind of videos, please let me know. Put a like, put a thumbs up, leave a comment, and I will make sure that I help you in the future with more videos about how to select good quality koi.